Hello, my beautiful loves. Welcome to your love reading for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus sign. So let's go ahead and start with some channeled messages here, Pisces. So Pisces, I'm hearing no apology forthcoming, okay? So I feel here, Pisces, maybe you hurt somebody, maybe somebody hurt you. Somebody does not have remorse over this. Somebody has no guilt, no, like, they just don't care. Okay, someone here just doesn't care. I feel that we have a situation where one person is offering a very beautiful future to somebody. Somebody is saying, you know, listen, you know, I'll take care of you financially, or, you know, I'll take care of you, I love you, I want forever with you, you know what I'm saying? But they're being treated very unfairly. They're being treated very unfairly because somebody here has no true passion or want to live with somebody or to move in with somebody or to get married to somebody. Someone doesn't have that true love and desire in their heart. They don't really want it. Do you see what I'm saying? So when they do things to hurt in the connection, they don't feel bad because they genuinely just don't care about the connection. And guys, I know that sounds cruel and I know that sounds mean, but, you know, if you're just not in love with somebody, it makes sense. The part that is cruel and mean is that it would appear to me that someone here must be stringing the other person along, making them think that there's a chance for that beautiful Ten of Pentacles long-term stability. Do you see what I'm saying? That's the messed up part. We are all entitled to, you know, not have feelings for somebody or to have feelings for somebody. This person is not an evil person because they're not in love with the other person. What does make them, you know, not the greatest person ever is that they're not saying, listen, you know, I just don't feel the same way. Do you understand? So what they're doing is they're hurting somebody that is willing to truly offer, you know what I'm saying, real stability, real love, real commitment, you know, financial stability, a future with somebody. They're hurting somebody that's offering that when they have no true desire for this connection. Tell me about Pisces, please. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs. Okay. Five of Wands in the reverse. You'll notice, Pisces, that this person doesn't fight for you, doesn't fight for this connection. They are not jealous whatsoever, okay? They are not jealous whatsoever. Three of Swords in this in reverse. You'll come to realize that this person never gets hurt by anything that you do, okay? Five of Pentacles, you're constantly living in fear here that this person is going to leave or that the connection is going to end. And we have the Strength card here. With the Seven of Swords in the reverse. You feel like this person is very restrained around you, Pisces. Like they don't, you know, what's the word I'm looking for? Like this, you can tell that they don't, you can tell that they don't want you. That's, you know what I'm saying? You can tell that, like, you know, there's not that type of passion about them where, like, they look at you and they have to, like, control themselves to not touch you or to not be around you. This person genuinely, like, they don't fight. They don't care. You'll find that they never get upset over anything that you do. You know, I mean, I know relationships where there's a lot of arguing, you know, isn't healthy, but there has to be some, if someone never argues with you or never has a problem with you, they genuinely just, you know, don't care. You know, they don't care. And like I said, with the Five of Pentacles here and the Strength card, I feel like you maybe feel like this person is like one foot out the door. Seven of Swords, this person's lying. You know what I'm saying? They're lying, cheating. Three of Cups, there may be a third party. And with the Sun card, you're realizing this. I feel like you're awakening to the fact that, you know, maybe there is someone else in the picture, possibly. Okay, let's see what we have here clarity guidance and love messages for Pisces. Or this person may look at third party energies a lot. I heard that too with the Sun card. This person may have a wandering eye, where they're constantly, their attention is constantly drawn in other places. Tell me about Pisces, please. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Tell me about the Five of Wands in the reverse. We've got the Hierophant, Taurus energy. Tell me about the Three of Swords in the reverse and the Ten of Pentacles in the reverse. Pisces, I feel like this person maybe is just in this connection for financial stability. I feel like they, you know what I'm saying, they don't really care. You know what I'm saying? That the only way you might be able to hurt this person is financially, like if you take their finances away. But I don't, they're not going to be heartbroken if you leave. You see what I'm saying? They're not going to be heartbroken if they, you know, you're offering that Ten of Pentacles is what I was feeling that you're offering. A beautiful future, abundance, happiness, joy. They wouldn't really care if they didn't get it. They don't see that future with you. They don't, you know what I'm saying? But with the Hierophant there, they do like the stability. They do like knowing that, you know, my future is going to be okay because Pisces is there. So that's why they're not letting this go. That's why we have that string along effect happening. But with the Lover's card here, you know, I feel like there is a beautiful love connection here, but that snake is sitting over it, staring at it. So there is something here that isn't quite right. A lie, like standing in between you guys. There's always like this big pink elephant in the room that I feel, you feel, Pisces. You know that it's there. You know something isn't right. Tell me about the Five of Pentacles. We've got the Page of Swords in the reverse. When this person tells you that they're never going to leave you or whatever the case may be, they're not being honest. They're not being honest. Tell me about the Strength card here for Pisces. The Strength card for Pisces. Ten of Wands in the reverse. I feel like this person actually wants to let go of the connection. I feel like they're actually holding back from letting go of the connection. Yeah, I feel like there might be someone here that's on this person's mind, because we've got the King of Pentacles, we've got the Lover's card, we've got the Knight of Swords, the Empress here, and the Eight of Swords with the Two of Cups. So Pisces, you might be dealing with somebody here that, you know, if they've got a child with somebody or if they were married to somebody, they have someone here that they already see as an emperor or an empress in their mind. Do you understand? So I feel like this is someone that, you know, is just infatuated with this person. And if they had the opportunity to do so, this person would run to that person to have a relationship with them. There's a love there. Do you understand what I'm saying? I feel like this person kind of sits with you. They like the stability. They like the money. They like being taken care of. But I feel that, you know, you are aware that this person, you know, would drop this connection at any time. And I feel like it's like that because there is a third party in the picture that this person wants more. And if that window of opportunity opened up, they would go run and be there. Okay. And with that Empress card, it could be possible that this is a baby mama or a baby daddy. It could be possible that this is a wife or a husband. So Pisces, if you're with someone who is stating that they're in separation from their husband or wife, that they're going to get a divorce, this is someone that 100% wants their marriage to work. Or, you know, it could just be that, you know, this is somebody that has a third party that they have on a pedestal. You know, this could just be somebody on the outside that they've never slept with before or even been with before, but they have their eye on that third party person. And if that third party person just said, yep, yeah, no, I'll date you, this person would be out in a heartbeat. Okay. Clarity, guidance, love messages here for my beautiful Pisces. Clarity, guidance, love messages for my beautiful Pisces. Now, Pisces, you might be doing this to somebody, you know, you might just be staying in a connection because it's comfortable, you know. So we've got the Moon here, Cancer Piscean energy. We have the Nine of Wands. We've got the Judgment card, and we've got the Six of Wands. So what we have here is someone with secrets, Pisces. Someone here is very defensive. Like if you say anything to them, they become very defensive because they have secrets. They're not telling the truth, okay? With the Judgment card and the Six of Wands, I feel like this person is just making decisions that are best for them. We've got the Emperor here. Yeah, the Lovers and the Five of Cups with the Six of Cups. This may be somebody, Pisces, that is still sprung on an ex. They have a lot of guilt and regret over an ex. But either way, you know, whether it's an ex or whether it's somebody that they feel a very strong soul tie connection that they have not been, it could be someone totally new that they have not been with before, but they're infatuated with that person because they feel a strong soul tie connection with them. Or it could be someone from the past. With the Emperor here, this person is not going to give in and tell you that. You can argue until your teeth fall out your head. Okay, this person is going to stand their ground and 100% stare at you in the face and tell you that they don't have feelings for anyone else, that they don't want anyone else, that, you know what I'm saying? They're never going to open up. With the Judgment card and the Six of Wands, this person is not stupid. They're going to make decisions that are victorious. And they know right now that if there's no chance with the ex, or if there's no chance, whoever this Empress energy is, if there's no chance with that person, they are sitting very pretty where they are, and they're not going to mess that up unless there's a chance with that Empress energy. Do you see what I'm saying? So you can argue and argue and argue. You know what I'm saying? Even if your intuition is telling you that something's not right, you can argue and argue and argue, but this person is not about to mess up a perfectly good situation when there's no chance with that third party issue. You know what I'm saying? Tell me about the Moon card here for Pisces, please. We've got the Nine of Cups. Tell me about the Nine of Wands for Pisces. And we've got the Ace of Pentacles. So Pisces, again, I feel like this person has a secret, and their secret is that their wish fulfillment is to start a new beginning elsewhere. Okay. To start a new beginning elsewhere. But again, they're never in a million years going to admit that to you ever. Okay. They're never going to tell you, you know, yeah, oh, I want that person, or yeah, I want that ex back. It will never, they'll die before they tell you the truth. Tell me about the Judgment card here. We've got the Eight of Pentacles. This person has made a decision to put the work in and do what is right. Tell me about the Six of Wands and the Page of Pentacles. Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo energy. Yeah, I feel like, Pisces, until this person receives a message of, hey, let's work this out from the ex, or let's just say this is someone in the workplace or someone that they go to college with or school with, until this third party person gives a message of, let's go ahead and work on this and let's go ahead and do this, until this person receives a message of, I'm going to get what I want, do you see what I'm saying? They're going to continue to lie. You see with the Star card here, the Knight of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy, Aquarian energy, the Strength card, and the Seven of Swords. Until this person gets the opportunity that they actually want, they're going to continue to just lie to you. And, you know, with that Strength card, again, they're being refrained from what they truly want. So they'll just keep up the lie. They'll keep up the farce because they're comfortable where they are. Someone here is comfortable where they are. So while they're waiting to actually get what they want, do you understand what I'm saying? It's a great, you know, being with you is a great place to be. So, and I feel, Pisces, that you know that. You can sense it because you see that this person has no jealousy, no issues, no problems. No, it's just not normal. I know, I mean, that's quite opposite. You know, normally people come to me as a reader like, we fight too much, I just want it to end. It's the opposite in this connection. You're dealing with someone that literally has no jealousy, will not fight for the connection. If you get upset, slam the door and leave. This person is not chasing nobody. You know what I'm saying? This person doesn't give a shit. They do not care. They don't care. You could, you know, sleep with a football team and this person wouldn't even blink an eye. This person doesn't care. You know, they don't care. They're in this just because they're comfortable where they are until they get to where they're trying to go. And if they never get to where they're trying to go, then you'll be with this person forever, you know, but they're just, you know, waiting for something else to happen. Tell me about the challenge here for Pisces. The challenge for Pisces. Ooh. Oh, you got a lot of cards here. Okay. The Justice card and the reverse Libra energy. Pisces, this is so unfair to you. It is so unfair to you. We have the Nine of Cups, the Ten of Cups in the reverse, the Three of Cups in the reverse and the Seven of Swords in the reverse. And again, the Ten of Pentacles under the deck. Pisces, the challenge here is that this is so unfair to you because you are doing everything that you can to fulfill this person's wishes. You're bending over backwards to make this person happy. But with the Ten of Cups in the reverse, there is no love here. This person just has no love whatsoever. Three of Cups in the reverse and the Seven of Swords in the reverse. The Seven of Swords in the reverse talks about sneaking away, okay, just sneakily getting away from a situation. Three of Cups in the reverse is an indication that this person is not where they want to be with that third party. They haven't reconciled with someone from the past, or they're not being accepted in going out on a date or getting with this third party energy. But I feel like that's the only thing that's stopping them from sneaking away. If this Three of Cups should be in the upright, this person would be out in a heartbeat. Do you see what I'm saying? They would be out in a heartbeat, and it's not fair to you. It's not fair to you, Pisces, because, you know, with the Nine of Cups and the Ten of Pentacles, you're offering this person like a dream come true. You're offering this person what most people would die to have. Do you see what I'm saying? Financial stability, emotional, you know, contentment. You're truly giving this your absolute all. And again, Pisces, this could be vice versa, you know, but I feel like someone here is like really, you know, giving, it's just very unfair. It's very unfair. Tell me about the outcome here for Pisces. The outcome here for Pisces. The outcome for Pisces, please. Okay. All right, so we've got the Eight of Cups in the reverse. We've got the Queen of Swords, Aquarius, Gemini, Libra energy. We have the Four of Cups, and we have the Page of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy, and the Six of Swords. Pisces, make no mistake that as this person is with you, they are continuing to either return to an ex, and I'm going to say specifically return to an ex because with the Eight of Cups, you know, this is returning to someone that you once had love for. Now, if it's not that they're trying to get back with an ex, it's somebody that they are in love with. Like, it's a third party that they want to date, that they want to be with. But with the Queen of Swords, this person has no interest, okay? This person has no interest. So I haven't seen the Six of Cups, so I'm not going to say it's an ex. But the Eight of Cups can talk about returning to something. And so can, you know, the Six of Swords. So this is either someone from their past that they want to get back with, or it's just someone else that they have in their life that they really want to be with, but this person doesn't want to be with them, okay? But this person is going to continue trying. With the Page of Cups and the Four of Cups, they're going to continue, hey, will you go out with me? No, I don't want to go out with you. Okay, see that Four of Cups, they keep getting rejected. Hey, you know, I'm so sorry, I still want to be with you. I don't care, stop calling me. I'm not taking you back, we're done. Do you see what I'm saying? So this person, the outcome here is that this person is going to continue to keep trying, Pisces. And, you know, with that Six of Swords energy, they are looking. Yeah, see, Six of Swords, the Death card, and the Six of Cups with the Five of Cups. This person still has a lot of sorrow in their heart over an ex. As much as I want to say it could be a different third party, and it is possible that it is, do you understand? I really feel strongly this is someone that they already know. It could be a childhood friend. It could be, you know what I'm saying? It could be a childhood friend that they've been in love with for a long time, and this person doesn't want to be with them. Or it could be an ex, but I feel like this person is just waiting to end things with you and go back to this person, okay? So, you know, you can offer as much as you want, but this person is still knocking on the ex's door, and if that ex opens the door and says, okay, come in, let's talk, this relationship's over. Regardless of how much you kill yourself, no matter what you buy them, no matter what, you know, how you twist yourself, you could just kill yourself giving this person all the love. And what most people would be like, oh my God, you are the luckiest man or woman in the world that you have Pisces. You can do whatever you're going to do. You can look hot, go to the gym, stand on your head, do tricks, do whatever. It doesn't matter to this person. They do not care. If this past person or whoever this third party is opens that door just a crack, this relationship's over. They will go back. Okay? All right, guys. I love you so much and take care. Bye, my loves.